All right, so today's race day, and we've got everybody loaded up. We're fixing to head out. Next stop is La Paz, Mexico, which is 1,000 miles away. Our first fuel stop will be at 600. Our second stop will be on the other side of 950. So we got quite a ways to burn off this morning just to get there. So as you can see, the guys are ready. As you can see, they're ready, and we are heading out. All right, kids, so we made it out here to Bay of LA. It's our first stop. We're gonna make radio contact and then move on. They're gonna come out here on the Bay of LA Road, which is out here, and it runs all the way east to Bay of LA. At this point, they've gone about 300 miles, and they're gonna come down for a splash of fuel and maybe a tire if they've got a flat. If not, then they're gonna haul ass past us and keep on going. So we're gonna keep on going and make the trip on up to Negro Guerrero, and then on to Laredo. So hang in there. So I'm out here in the desert, and I've been told to find truck team 88 because they have a rear link arm, and they're supposed to be parked up here on Bay of LA Road, which is where I am. So, and they're supposed to be parked up here on Bay of LA Road, which is where I am. So I've walked about a mile looking for truck 88, and there's some more trucks parked up here, truck teams. And so I'm gonna keep going until I get to the truck 88. They're supposed to be on this road somewhere. Hopefully it's this group up here.
That was Monster.
Monster? Well, that was a bust. We need to find a rear control arm for the truck, or we're done. So I'm going back to the pit stop to tell them that I didn't find it, or the team that we were looking for, and we're gonna see what our other options are. So hang in there. All right, so we're out here in Bay of LA on Bay of LA Road, about 30 clicks west of Bay of LA, waiting for the trophy truck, and we got word that it had been turned over. And we were about to head back, and we got another word that said stay where we were because they were going to be working on it. So we don't know if they're still coming or not. The other issue today has been fuel. We went into Bay of LA to get fuel. They didn't have any, which was what we were counting on to get us to our next stop. So we used our reserve fuel to get us back here, and we can get into the next town, which will have fuel, hopefully. It's amazing that you would think that they would have fuel out here. And this is one of those things that could end this race for us, is just fuel. It's all about making sure that you have enough fuel to get to point A to point B, and to finish the race. So, you know, if we can finish the race, that's primary, and then secondary is to place in the race. So we're waiting on word to hear if we're going to be going back to Estero Beach. If they get the truck running, we'll keep going. If not, then it's party time. All right. So basically our instructions are to enjoy the race, which is kind of shitty because I didn't come here to watch the race. I came here to be in the race. But, you know, making the best of the situation, we cranked us up a little fire. And so we're going to kick back until we hear otherwise, and, you know, make the best of it. So here we go.
Having a bunch of fuel in these things.
Yeah.
We're gonna have to get it back into the barrels. So.
Yeah. We'll figure it out.
Yeah.
All right, so we just got confirmation that they got the truck fixed, and they are going to be rolling in here in about two hours, which puts us 4 hours behind the mark. So we basically filled up the fuel tank from the fuel drum, and we're sitting around.
Yeah.
We're sitting here waiting for them to show up. So I just want to show you something real quick. The way this system works, this is called a gravity-fed system. And what we do is we take fuel out of that 55-gallon drum through that pump into a hose that is right here. I don't know if you can see that or not, but there. So that hose right there. So that opening right there is where we fill the tank, and this is our vent. So what we do is when we get ready to fuel, we close both of these and we run the hoses. There's a hose on top. I don't know if you can see that, but there's a hose on top, and then there's another hose that comes out the back, which is what you see right there. So that hose goes into the truck, and it feeds the truck. Now, the reason it's a closed system is because you don't want fumes in the top, and because it creates a fire hazard. The other thing is that conventional thinking would lead you to believe that you need a vent on top, because when you pour a gas can, when you pour gas and you don't have a vent, the gas doesn't flow. Well, that's why you have two hoses. So one is a vent for the fuel tank on the truck, and the other, and that feeds into the top of this this fuel box here, which creates the flow of air and fuel in itself. So it's a closed system. Now we also have a dead man switch, which is on the other side there, and that is there for emergency shutoff. So if something happens,
that's there to give Ricky something to do.
So the dead man switch is essentially my job, and if something happens and we have something catastrophic go off, my job is to shut off the fuel, and we have the Frenchie there. He's gonna have the fire hydrant because he's a fireman. So he's gonna man the fire hydrant. I'm gonna man the dead man switch. Robert's gonna be on the fuel hose. As soon as the trophy truck pulls in, they're gonna take the fuel hose, pop it in the back of the truck, fuel the truck, and we're gonna get them on down the road. So we are now officially back in the race. So here we go. All right, so it's 12:15. We just got a radio message that they're on their way in, so they should be here in about 20 minutes. Looks like they fixed the truck. So we're still in the race, and we're gonna fill up and go on to our stop at 600. So it's gonna be a long night, man, but we're here, so.